Hello and welcome to the Django DRF project, eCommerce. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials which you can watch for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. This course is also available on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Okay, let's start a new project. Now, just before we start, make sure that you have Python installed. We are utilizing Visual Studio Code in this project. You can use any code editor that you prefer, of course. And then to manage or to introduce source control in this project, we're going to start utilizing GitHub Desktop. So do make sure that everything is installed, ready to go. Check out the installation guides at the start of this course, and then we can get started. To get this project started, we are going to need a project folder. Here on my desktop, I'm going to add a new folder. Now, you can put this folder absolutely anywhere you like. I'm just going to, just for simplicity, add it here onto the desktop. And then once we introduce source control, we'll move all the source over to the GitHub repository. So for this project, I'm just going to name this project for now, Django DRF eCommerce. Okay, so that's my project folder. Now that we have our new folder created, let's go ahead and open up Visual Studio Code. Here on the Mac, I've used the command space and I've just typed in Visual Studio Code. That will open up Visual Studio Code. And the first task is to then open up a new repository. Open up our project folder. So let's go over to the top. Now you can't see the top ribbon. I'm aware of that. So I've selected file from the top. If you're on Windows and Mac, it might be slightly different. And you're just looking for open folder. Now, typically you've got this option here to open a folder as well. So I can just go over to the desktop, go into my new folder and select yes. So this is the folder here on the left-hand side. So if I add something here, say test.txt. So this folder here is representing our folder we have here. So you can see inside of it now, we do have a file. So if you weren't too sure of that, or if you've never used Visual Studio Code before, you can see how that works. All right, so let's get rid of that. I'm just going to press Command Delete, move that to the trash. We are going to be working within a virtual environment. So I'm going to open up the terminal. Now I use the hotkeys there. So if I go over to the view from the ribbon at the top, which you can't see, and then terminal, you can see that's a hotkey. Now, if you are new to Visual Studio Code, do check out the guide at the start of this course, where I take you through a new operating system, just take you through some of the basics of utilizing Visual Studio Code. This is just one of them. So I've opened up the terminal here, utilizing the hotkeys, or just drag from the bottom if you prefer. And now let's go ahead and create a virtual environment. Now, again, I've given you the instructions for your particular operating system, Windows or Mac, and I will maybe update this eventually if I haven't already done so, and include Linux. So what we need to do here on the Mac, I'm just going to type in Python 3, use the M flag, and then create a virtual environment. So the second name here is the name of the folder. So you can call this whatever you like, but generally I just tend to call it VEMV, but there's no convention here. Use whatever you like. Right, so now we need to activate. We need to actually go into our virtual environment. So let's go ahead and do that by typing in, on the Mac at least, source. So on Windows, you don't need to do that. So source, and then just navigate to the folder. Inside of that folder, we have a bin. And inside of that, we have then the activate. So if you're on Windows, it's going to be slightly different. It's going to be vmv, and then scripts, and then activate, and without utilizing source. Okay. Right, so whether you're Mac or Windows, you should now have the virtual environment activated. You can see the prefix here. It says VEMV in the terminal. So we're now inside of our virtual environment. So we can now use the Python package index. We can use the Python package manager pip to download Django from the Python package index. If you're not too familiar with that, then just type in Python package index into Google. Take a look. It's a large repository of packages which we can download and use for our Django or for our Python projects or within our Python projects. Okay, so pip install, let's go for Django. So we're going to download Django from the Python package index, pypy.com. So we'll do that first. So it looks like Django's current version is 4.1.4. That's what I'm looking at here. So if you are using a later or an earlier version, don't worry. As long as you're utilizing, say, Django version 3.9 upwards, then pretty much everything in this first phase should be exactly the same. Because it's sometimes impossible to recognize all the issues when Django is updated, and if you are looking to utilize a latest version of Django for this project, then please let me know if you do have any problems with any latest versions of software packages that you utilize within the project, and I will try and make sure that I keep all the code and videos up to date. So now we have that installed, I'm going to just on Windows, you can type in CLS. So on the Mac here, I'm going to type or press Command and K just to clear that. So now that we have Django installed, we can now use the Django admin to start project. So we want to start a new project. Now we want to start a new project, so we need a project name. So I'm going to call this eCommerce. Okay, so what this is going to do is it's going to create a new project folder here called eCommerce. And inside of that project, there's going to be another folder called eCommerce. And that is going to be our main project folder. So maybe I'll call this DRF eCommerce. That's probably better. DRF eCommerce. Now, I could also include a dot here, which is a reference to where I want to start a project. So if I include the dot, I'm just going to have one folder, DRF eCommerce, and that's going to be my main project folder. If I don't include it, like I said, we're going to create a folder within a folder. And that is the setup. That's the setup that we're going to utilize. Okay, so let's give that a go. Okay, so you can see that we have a folder here. Inside of that, we have another folder. Now, I did stumble there when deciding the project folder. Now, I don't have any rationale as to why I've chosen this approach necessarily, other than, I suppose I do have a rationale, now I'm going to tell you it, but other than that I find it useful and I like to structure my project in this manner. Now, there isn't really any right or wrong way of structuring a project, whether you have the main project folder here in the main directory or whether you have it nested. I think that over time, as we develop this application, it'd be easier to explain why I feel this approach works for me personally. But like I said, you can structure and you may see other projects structured slightly differently. And like I said, ultimately, there isn't necessarily a right and wrong way here when creating a new project and where you add the Django project folders. So do change it if you prefer. So what we have now then is our Django project here. Inside of here, we have the Django project folder, our main project folder. And you can see we now have the manage.py file as well, which we can utilize now to run Django commands. Now, working in this way, we need to know a little bit more about the folder and file structure and how to navigate into folders, both in the folder and then moving out up the directory structure. So if I type in ls here I'm on the Mac, I can see that I have a list here of all the different folders. So this terminal is placed within our project folder and it's showing us here the two folders, as we can see here. When I type in ls to list all the folders inside of the current directory this terminal is placed within. So I can use cd to change directory, so I can move into a folder. Now I don't need to type in the whole folder name, I can just type in half or some of it and then press tab and it will finish off the folder name. So this is going to allow me to move the terminal into this folder. So when I type in ls now, you can see I'm inside this folder because I have the folder here called drfcommerce and the manage.py file. Now I want to be in this folder in this project, so then I can go ahead and run the manage.py file. So let's type in --/ manage.py and let's go ahead and run the server. Okay, so the server is running, suggesting now that our project has been installed successfully. You can go ahead and just check out the link if you like. It should just show the default Django holding page is what it should look like. So this just indicates the fact that our Django project was successfully installed. In the browser, if you weren't too sure, if you haven't used Django before, you can see that this was the link that I needed to type in. So HTTP and then this loopback address, which is an IP address that's assigned to our computer so that we can send requests to our own machine. And of course, this server is running on our machine. So therefore, it picks up that request that we've made in our browser and then serves our Django application. When you started the server, you may have seen this red text here, which suggests that there's actions to be taken. Don't worry about that for now. And you can see that when you access the server, we get some information regarding the actions that the server performed. Now, to return back to the terminal, because although we can type things here potentially, nothing is happening. So to get back into the terminal, we are told that we need to quit the server with Control C. So just type in Control C, press Control C, and then that takes you back to the terminal. Again, if you're completely new to Django, there is an introductory project at the start of this course for anyone who is new to Django. And I take you through the basics of working with Django, the virtual environment, and that is there to help you familiarize yourself with these basics of interfacing with Django and starting Django projects and so on. If that's not what you want to do, I do recommend that you make some notes. So Control C there, and then the URL that we utilize to access our Django project. This is all useful information that no doubt we'll use multiple times. So it's well worth making some notes to make it quicker and easier to follow the tutorial as we move along.